In Hebrew, what that says is, behold how good, and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. And one of the most powerful things we have as Christians, as people who walk with God, as people who talk to Jesus, as those who know Him intimately, is the ability to bless one another, to give each other a blessing, to, as it were in Hebrew, make a bracha, to give someone the presence of God by asking Him to bless them in a personal way, in an intimate way. Sometimes we're just simply saying, God, bless you. A lot of people don't realize how powerful that really is. Because when you ask God to do this, He is more than willing. It is His will to bless. It is His choice to bless. And we have that capability to involve God in touching another life, in touching someone in a way that we might not be able to reach out to them and to be intimate with them. So when we say, God bless you, recognize that God does. And the world has not yet seen it, but the church can do it. When together, we as a unit, we as a body, we as a family of God, bless someone or something, or even in the God bless America. So never doubt how much of a power goes forth from the Lord Himself to bless, to encourage, to cause His presence to be there in the midst of the thing or the person or the want or desire that we have when we say, God bless you. I know for myself today, because it's my birthday, which I don't normally celebrate, there's a huge blessing that has come upon me because of all the people that have taken the time, that have made time, that have gone out of their way, even if it's just a simple clip today, to say, God bless you on your birthday, to say, happy birthday, to give something of themselves to someone else that they only partially know. So, in all those ways, the blessing that has gone forth from the person always comes back to the same person who's blessed. So today, there's always a blessing you can do or a curse. And there's no reason to curse someone, but there's always a good reason to bless them. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. In daily life, the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name. If you knew the gift of God, and who it is that saith to you, give me the drink, you would have asked of Him, and He would have given you living water. If you, being evil, know how to give good gifts unto your children, how much more shall your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to them that ask Him? Verily, verily, I say unto you, whosoever and whatsoever you shall ask the Father in my name, He will give it to you. Hitherto have you asked nothing in my name. Ask, and you shall receive, that your joy may be full. You have not, because you ask not. When the Spirit of truth is come, He will guide you into all truth, for He shall not speak of Himself. But whatsoever He shall hear, that shall He speak. And He will show you things to come. He shall glorify Me, for He shall receive of Mine, and shall show it unto you. They rebelled and vexed His Holy Spirit. Therefore He was turned to be their enemy, and He fought against them. The Spirit of God has been given to us as a comforter, as one to encourage us, as one to empower us, as one to fill us with the peace of God that passes all understanding, with the love of God that is His very presence that causes us to know the peace and to enjoy the fullness of God. And with joy that we would be so content in realizing how much God loves us, and we would give His Spirit and place it inside us as a down payment until the day that we see Jesus face to face. If you do not know the Holy Spirit, if you have not received God, which implies the most you the knowledge of Jesus. And once you know it, once you know that you know that you know. What think ye of Christ? Lift up your heads, O ye gates. Even lift them up, everlasting doors. The King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. He hath on his vesture and on his thigh a name written, King of kings and Lord of lords. Unto you which believe he is precious, be unto them which be disobedient the stone which the builders disallowed, and the same is made the head of the corner. Christ crucified, unto the Jews a stumbling block, and unto the Greeks foolishness, but unto them that are called, both Jews and Greeks, Christ, the power of God, the wisdom of God. I count all things but loss for the excellency of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things, and do count them as dung, that I may win Christ. Lord, you know all things, and you know that I have loved you. It is my fervent prayer, my hope, and my confident expectation that you never, ever let anything, not house, not home, not wife, not car, not man cave, not woman cave, not shoes, not clothes, not status, not symbolism, not children, not anything, whether pastor, preacher, teacher, or any other person, or spirit, or God himself, separate you from Jesus and the love of God that is in him, that you might know the essence of knowledge of the person of Jesus Christ himself, so that you can walk with God today. You can talk with God today. You can know him in the most intimate, personal way, that you could be like Jesus and say, I see the Father. Because that's what God wants for you. He wants you to know him in the most tender, gentle, experiential way that you could say today, my Lord.